Soccer fans are a fickle bunch. Not long ago, David Beckham was the most hated man in English football, receiving a red card in a 1998 World Cup match versus Argentina that many believe to be the sole reason England didn't win the tournament that year. Fans are very upset, going so far as to burn his effigy in the streets. So, how did he bounce back and become the famous football player we know him as today? In 2001, he scored a curling free kick against Greece in the last minute of a qualifying game that sent them to the World Cup. If he hadn't scored that goal, England would have suffered the embarrassment of not even qualifying for the tournament at all. Beckham was a great player in his own right, but it was that singular curling free kick that put him back in the good graces of English fans. Today, I will be teaching you how to score a curling free kick like Beckham's, based on my own 15 years of soccer experience and research time. So, to begin with, what is a free kick? FIFA is soccer's governing body. According to their Laws of the Game rulebook for the 2017-2018 season, a direct free kick is a method of restarting association football following a foul. A goal may be scored directly against an opposing side without the ball having first touched another player. This is in opposition to an indirect free kick in which a ball must touch another player before it can be scored. The referee decides the difference between an indirect and a direct free kick at his own discretion, which is mostly based on the severity of the foul that stopped playing in the first place, like the difference between a shoulder tap or a two-footed tackle in another person's legs. So, your team has just been awarded a direct free kick. Now for the setup. The ideal range for a curling free kick is no more than 30 yards away from the goal. Any farther away, and curlers will be much easier for goalkeepers to react to. Their spin makes them a much slower travel speed towards the goal. Next, consider the position of the goalkeeper and the wall. Is your goalkeeper far post or near post? Is the wall obstructing the goalkeeper's view of you as the free kick taker? These are the factors that will help you determine where you're going to be aiming. In this instance, for example, the keeper is near post, and he sees closer to you instead of farther away from you, and the wall is obstructing his view of you as the free kick taker. Therefore, a right-footed player will want a curling free kick to the right post. That would be your best bet. Now for the actual kick. You're going to want to start about 4 to 5 strides back from the ball. Any farther away is going to be unnecessary for power. You're going to want to run up on the balls of your feet, like so, starting with small steps and transitioning to lengthening strides. However, when you approach the ball, you don't want to be leaning back with too long of a stride. Otherwise, once you kick the ball, you will undercut it and set it over the crossbar, causing you to miss. So, where should you hit it? You should make contact with the ball slightly underneath the equator, and if you're a right-footed player, to the outside of the ball, like so. Your foot should make contact at the instep, marked by the signs, just below the laces. According to orthopedic surgeon Vivan Pachwadi's 2015 article, Footbone Anatomy, this area, the instep, is made up primarily of the, what's it called again? The first metatarsal, making it a firm surface to strike the ball with. Your strike should also be slightly hooked to give the ball more speed and rotation as you make contact with it. Your motion of the hooked foot, however, should only be slight. Too much hook is going to lead to not enough speed, and it'll be much easier for the goalkeeper to react to it. Some players also like to leap a little bit with their plant foot once they've made contact with the ball. This helps them generate more upwards power when they kick the ball. Another method of scoring a curling free kick is known as a trivela. The word trivela originates from Brazilian Portuguese, and its most famous instance was done by Roberto Carlos versus France in 1997. The run-up is identical to before. You're going to be 4 to 5 strides back, and your contact is going to be identical on the foot and the ball as well. However, it's going to be inverted, meaning it's going to be on the outside of your foot instead of the inside. Your foot hooking motion must be much more exaggerated, however, than a regular curler. In Carlos's free kick, for example, he curved his kicking leg with enough force to rotate his entire body 90 degrees in midair. Your power must also be much greater for this kind of free kick to generate sufficient spin and speed, because your first metatarsal is not self-striking service. So, unless players have leg strength like Roberto Carlos here, they mostly stick to regular curlers. So, now that you've scored a Beckham or Roberto Carlos leg free kick, we can get down to the most important part, your celebration. You can copy some classics, such as kicking the corner flag, ripping off your jersey, or a simple knee slide towards the fans. But at the end of the day, you can do whatever you want. After all, you're the goal scorer. Thank you.
Okay, Eric, how was that?
So rough. I already
original president.